delight. God be my delight. God be my delight. God be my joy. God be my joy. God be my joy. More than anything, more than anything, more than anything. God be my delight. Come and be my delight. God be my joy. God be my joy. God be my joy. More than anything. More than anything. Don't wanna get lost in my own world. Don't wanna get lost inside my head. I wanna walk with you. I wanna walk in the spirit. Don't wanna get lost inside my head. Don't wanna live on my own. I wanna do life with you. I wanna do life with you. So come be my joy. And be my delight. Come be my joy. Thank you. inside my head. Don't wanna get lost inside my own world. I wanna do life with you. God, I wanna do life with you. I wanna listen. I wanna ask you questions. God, I wanna listen. And ask you questions. Cause it would be so easy to go through life just reacting to the moment, just reacting to the circumstances. Could be so easy. And sometimes that's what life looks like for me. But I don't want to do it that way. I wanna step back. I wanna pause. And listen to what you're saying. I wanna listen to what you're saying. It would be so easy to just kind of go through life on autopilot, just reacting to the present moment. I don't want to do life that way. No, I don't want to do life that way. I want to pause. I want to slow down. I wanna focus my attention on you, just to listen for what you say. I wanna listen to what you say. So come be my joy. Ooh. Come be my delight. Ooh. God be my joy. Be my delight. Be my delight. My delight. Isn't it better to do life with a friend? Isn't it better to do life with a friend? You want friendship with your people, God. I wanna slow down and pause and listen. I wanna be your friend. Gotta wanna be your friend. You made me. For communion, for community, not to live on my own, but to abide in Jesus, to walk with the Spirit. Isn't it better to do life with a friend? Isn't it better to do life with a friend? And in you are all the treasures of wisdom. In you all the treasures of knowledge. In you, in you, in you, in you. It would be so easy to just live life from my head. It would be so easy to just live life from my head. And sometimes I do. But God, I don't want to. I wanna live from my heart, connected to my heart, connected to who you are, God. Paying attention to what I'm feeling, paying attention to what you're saying, being present. Present with myself, present with you, present with others. Not a million miles away, lost in my own thoughts, lost in my head. 'Cause that's not living. God, I wanna do life with you. God, I wanna do life with you. Thank you. tell me stories of the God who feels. Tell me stories of the God who feels. Tell me stories of the God who feels. You're the God who feels. You're the God who feels. I remember when your heart was grieved, not long after the beginning. How upon the earth, and how wickedness had increased upon the earth, to the point where the only thought evil of the time. Where their thoughts, where their desires were continually and solely on evil. And it says your heart was grieved. It says your heart was grieved. Here's this world that you and made. Here's this creation you brought forth. All the creatures, the sky and the sea, and humanity. Remember what you said, God. It says, you saw all that you had made, and it was good. Beautiful creation, a beautiful world, a wonderful world. But after some generations, after some time had passed, it had gotten to the point where the thoughts of men the hearts of men, the desires of men were evil all the time, continually, solely toward evil all the time. What happened to your creation? What happened to all the good you had made? It says that you were grieved. God, you grieved. What does that mean when it says you were grieved? Tell me stories about the way you feel, how deeply you feel. You were God, but you feel things so deeply. You are the highest one, but you feel things so deep. You have emotions. I want to hear stories about the God who feels, the God who feels. Fast forward to the kings. David, a man after your own heart, and Solomon, the one loved by God. An emotion. It's more than an emotion, to be sure, but love has emotion. Love has emotion, to be sure. Yes, love is more than emotion, to be sure. but still love has emotion. God, what did you feel towards the man you said was after your own heart? What did you feel about his son? Solomon, the one you love, loved by God. And what about Josiah? How when he found the books of the law, he tore his clothes, he laid his face to the ground and he wept. He was grieved, for his eyes had seen just how far his nation had gone off course. And then the prophetess came with a message, and she said, the Lord says, because your heart was tender, your response was tender when you heard the book of the law read in your presence. Your heart was tender. To recognize tenderness inside a man, that means your heart is tender, God. We're made in your image. In the image of God we were created. So if you're recognizing tenderness inside a king, what does it say about you? The tenderness in your heart. What about when you spoke through Isaiah? You said that you lead gently those who are with young. You gently lead those who are with the young ones. You lead them gently. What does that say about your heart? There's a gentleness inside you, a tenderness inside you, a grief that comes over you when your creation turns away. Pain enters your heart. Tell me stories about the God who feels. Tell me stories about the God who feels. You're the God who grieves. You're the God who gets angry. You're the God who rejoices. You're the God who dances. You're the God who sings. You're the God who weeps. Tell me stories about the God who feels. Tell me stories about the God who feels. my heart locked up. If you feel so deeply, God, why is my heart so locked up? Maybe it's okay to feel. Maybe it's okay. Maybe it's important to pay attention to what we're feeling, not to be ruled by them. But to be aware of them. It's been said that children are like it's been said that emotions are like children in a car. No, they can't drive. You can't put the children in the driver's seat, but you can't put them in the trunk. They need attention. Yes, sometimes boundaries, but they need attention. You can't ignore them. So why is my heart locked up? Have we taken emotions and thrown them in the trunk in the name of wisdom? Have we taken our emotions and thrown them in the trunk in the name of wisdom? It's true, we can't let them drive the car, but we can't shut them out. They need attention. Maybe sometimes they need boundaries, but you can't pretend that they're not there. You can't pretend that they're not there. And God, he feels things so deeply. So maybe it's okay for me to feel. If our God feels things so deeply, maybe it's okay for me to feel. Maybe it's important for me to feel. What if it's critical for me to feel?